In this video, we're going to discuss the vehicles on Gran Turismo 5 which you may never have owned when the game was released. These include pre-order bonus cars, vehicles released for specific events, and more. I hope you enjoy watching. We're going to start with two pre-order bonus cars, beginning with the 2010 Joey Logano No. 20 GameStop Toyota Camry 2010. To access this vehicle, you had to pre-order Gran Turismo 5 from GameStop in North America. So, if you got the game from elsewhere, or like me, you're from another country that doesn't even have GameStop, then you won't have been able to get it. Logano originally planned to use this livery at the 2010 Tums Fast Relief 500 at Martinsville Speedway, held on the 24th of October 2010. But due to a delay in the game's release, he never ended up using it, which is a big shame. The second pre-order bonus car that I wanted to mention is the Chevrolet Camaro SS Edge Special. To get this car, players had to purchase some Edge shaving gel, head to the company's website and redeem the code there. Not only did you have to purchase the special Edge shaving gel product with the promotion, but you had to redeem the code before June 2011, as that's when the special website that Edge had set up was shut down, making it impossible to redeem after this date. The car has a special violet colour with GT logos on the front and sides. It also has unique wheels and is unable to be resprayed. Although if it's resprayed via hacking, then it'll change to grey, no matter what colour you try to respray it. But it still retains the GT logo at the front and the small Gran Turismo logos on the sides. Next we have the Toyota FT86 2 Concepts 11. Now this is a vehicle that you would have had a better chance of owning in this game, as it was available to all players. But it wasn't as simple as just buying or winning it. Let me explain. This car was added in version 2.02, and to access it, you had to purchase the Complete Pack 1 DLC, but then also purchase an additional item within the Complete Pack 1, such as a paint pack or a racing gear pack. Then you'd receive a gift card coupon to receive the car in one of two colours, orange metallic or silky black. Nowadays, it's impossible to purchase the DLC, rendering the car inaccessible without hacking. There was another DLC car that players could receive via a similar method. The Gran Turismo Racing Kart 125 SPL is a version of the Racing Kart 125 with a different livery. To access this, players had to purchase more than one of any DLC, such as paint packs, and then they'd receive a gift card coupon to get this car. Since DLC is no longer an option for GT5, this vehicle is now inaccessible without hacking or mods. The colours available for this car are red, black, green, blue, purple, and bronze. One strange thing I found with this kart was that in the dealership and in your garage on the GT5 Master mod, there is a black colour scheme for it. However, when you drive it, it changes to blue. So I'm not sure what's going on there. Our next lot of cars refer to GT Academy, the competition run by Gran Turismo and Nissan from 2008 to 2016, as a way for sim racers to enter the world of mainstream motorsport. The first GT Academy car to showcase is the Nissan Leaf G GT Academy 11. The first round of the GT Academy 2012 competition took place between the 1st of May and the 25th of June 2012. If you managed to get all gold awards on the challenges within round 1, you would receive the Nissan Leaf as a reward. Therefore, it was available for a little under 2 months. The Leaf was available in 6 different colours: Radiant Red, Super Black, Brilliant Silver, White Pearl, Aqua Blue and Aurora Flare Blue Pearl. But it can be resprayed at GT Auto. Our second GT Academy car is the Nissan Silvia Spec Car Aero GT Academy 02. This was another car that was used in the 2012 GT Academy competition. Players had to complete all challenges in round 2 with all gold awards. Again, players only had a little under 2 months to complete these requirements and unlock the Silvia. Colours for this car were Lightning Yellow, Active Red, Brilliant Blue, Super Black, Sparkling Silver, and Pearl White, although it can be resprayed. The vehicle that featured in round 3 was the Nissan Skyline GTR V-Spec 2 GT Academy 94. Again, the same criteria had to be met within the time frame to be awarded this car. Also, I believe that you would have only received one gift ticket, so I'm not sure whether you would have been able to access the GT Academy cars in all their colours. I believe trading was an option for at least some of these cars, so perhaps you were lucky enough to know someone who aced the GT Academy challenges and was happy to trade their prizes. The colour schemes for this car were crystal white, red pearl metallic, black pearl, spark silver metallic, gun grey metallic and aurora flare blue pearl. This is another car that can be resprayed at GT Auto as well. The car featured in round 4 was the Nissan 370Z GT Academy 08. Another vehicle that's considered very rare these days due to the limited time window it was available for. And of course, you still had to get all gold awards on all challenges within round 4 as well. The 370Z came in 9 colours as standard. Brilliant white pearl, brilliant silver, blade silver, titanium grey, diamond black, aurora flare blue pearl, premium Le Mans blue, vibrant red and premium ultimate yellow. Or you can respray it in a colour of your choosing. Round 5 out of 8 saw players take control of the Nissan Skyline GTR V-Spec 2 NER GT Academy 02. If you managed to get all golds in the challenges of round 5, then you would have received this car as a gift. Its stock colours are black pearl, sparkling silver, white, white pearl, millennium jade, bayside blue and aurora flare blue pearl. And it's resprayable at GT Auto. Okay, round 6. The featured car was the Nissan GTR Black Edition GT Academy 12. As you can see, we're gradually taking control of quicker cars as the rounds go by. This is considered to be another rare or hidden car these days, as it was no longer available after the 2012 GT Academy competition had finished, unless this car was tradable. Stock colours are vibrant red, meteor flake black pearl, dark metal grey, ultimate metal silver, brilliant white pearl and aurora flare blue pearl, although you could respray it in a colour of your choice. The penultimate round of GT Academy 2012 featured the Nissan GTR Black Edition tuned car, GT Academy 12, an improved version of the GTR from round 6. If you got all golds in round 7, then this car would have found its way into your garage. If not, then sadly you would have missed the boat. According to GT Fandom, it cannot be purchased, traded, won or obtained in any other way. Until now actually, whereby we can drive these cars once more, thanks to the creators of the Gran Turismo 5 Master Mod. I have them to thank for all the cars I'm able to show you in this video. All the colours for this car are the same as the standard car used in the previous round of GT Academy, and you can respray it. The final round of GT Academy in 2012 gave players the opportunity to drive and unlock the Nissan 370Z tuned car GT Academy 08, an improved version of the car that participants used in round 4. Like the others, you'd receive a gift ticket to get this car if you achieved all golds in this round. The stock colours for this car are the same as the standard cars. There was also a second version of this car as well. The difference is that the one that's gifted from GT Academy has the year 2012 on the sides, whereas the alternate version has the word PS3 in its place. This second version of the car is also revered as one of the rarest cars in the game. It was available as a prize car, with the probability of 3.6% being awarded from a level 12 ticket, and a 0.096% chance of being awarded from a 1000 ticket. GT players generally consider this car to be the rarest prize car in the game. The colour schemes for this version of the car are the same, except it isn't available in Aurora Flare Blue Pearl as standard. Well, that covers all 8 rounds of GT Academy 2012, but actually there was another vehicle that was intended to appear in GT Academy, but never ended up being used. And it's the Nissan Skyline Coupe 370 GT GT Academy version 07. Yes, this was likely intended to be driven in one of the rounds, but for unknown reasons, it was cut. However, this vehicle remains in the game's files. So once again, thanks to the Gran Turismo 5 Master Mod, it can be resurrected and driven for the first time. Colours for this car are Super Black, Fountain Blue, Vibrant Red, Stratosphere Blue, Lunar Mare Silver, Brilliant Silver, White Pearl, and Aurora Flare Blue Pearl, of course, which is a staple of the GT Academy cars. There was also another GT Academy branded car, the Nissan GTR Spec V GT Academy Special. This vehicle was originally given out to all players who participated in GT Academy in 2011. So therefore, if you didn't take part, then you would have missed your first opportunity to acquire the GTR. Yes, that's right, unlike the other GT Academy cars we've looked at, players had a second opportunity to get this one. There was a special seasonal event during the last 2 months of 2011, and again it was given out to participants. But after this, it was never offered as a prize car ever again. Also, you can't respray it. I should also mention that there's one last car with GT Academy branding. The Nissan GTR Spec V GT Academy version 09. However, this car was not used in the GT Academy event. Instead, it can be acquired by getting all golds on the S license tests. So therefore, you can still access this vehicle without the need for hacking. Now we move on to what I think are the most exciting cars in this video. All from the Gran Turismo manufacturer on GT5. Okay, first up, we have a trio of vehicles. The Gran Turismo Red Bull X2010 5G. We're going to discuss two of the three versions for starters. And that's because they're quite similar. The only difference being that one has Pirelli logos over the front wheels, and the other one doesn't. The X2010 5G was used exclusively in the Red Bull 5G Gaming Championship, which was a seasonal event in Japan only. And despite being used in the event, to my knowledge, it wasn't even gifted to participants. It was only playable in the event itself. This car has a unique appearance, different to the other X2010s, and is actually a detuned version of the standard model. The fan system has been disabled, it has reduced horsepower, and a passive suspension system. Also, it has 20 colour schemes. So to save you guys some time, I'll show half of them using the version with Pirelli logos, and the other 10 colour schemes using the version without the logos. Both versions have the same 20 schemes. The third variant appears to be a copy of the Gran Turismo Red Bull X2010 S Vettel version. However, according to the Cutting Room Floor website, this variant has the performance parameters of the coloured X2010 and the prototype. The description for all three of the X2010s is also reused for this variant. It's not exactly known why it has all these characteristics. Aside from the 5G variant, there is another special Red Bull X2010 that went unused in Gran Turismo 5, but remained in the game's code. From version 2 to version 2.12, where it became inaccessible. The car in question is the Gran Turismo Red Bull X2010 JP Flag Colour. This was a special variant of the X2010, which was apparently created for an unfinished DLC pack for charity. A line from the car's description in-game reads, "This particular version wears the colours of the Japanese flag, to support the recovery of Japan from the Great East Earthquake that hit the Tohoku region on March 11th, 2011. Polyphony Digital's intention seems to have been for players to purchase some downloadable content that included this car, with the profits going to the relief effort. But for whatever reason, this never happened, and the vehicle was never made accessible to players. During the development of the game, the X2010 wasn't yet named the X2010. It was referred to as the Polyphony Digital X1. and in a pre-release version of Gran Turismo that was discovered, the Polyphony Digital X1 was found. Luckily for me, it's also in the Gran Turismo 5 Master Mod. Now, I think it's likely that it was modded in after being found in the beta build, rather than being among Gran Turismo 5's files, but I'm not 100% sure on this. Anyway, it does have some visual differences. The head-up display looks different, its headlights don't work, and it also lacks an in-game description. But here it is, the car that would go on to be the X2010. There's also a second pre-release version of the X2010 that was added into the Master Mod as well, also likely from the QA build of GT5. It's the Red Bull X2010 S Vettel Old, an unfinished version of the X2010 S Vettel. It's pretty hard to find any information on this specific vehicle, but as you can see, some of the textures are missing from around the front headlights. If you spot any additional differences, let me know in the comments. In version 2.09, there was a strange vehicle that was added to the Gran Turismo manufacturer in the dealerships, and its name is XXXXXXX. It's an almost identical version of the Chevrolet Corvette C7 test prototype, with the only visual difference seemingly being a missing Corvette rear license plate. Then you have its name, which is just 7 X's. And it's also strange that it sits under the Gran Turismo manufacturer, not Chevrolet. Naturally, this car was never meant to be accessible, and is likely an unused version of the C7 prototype. In version 2.12, this car was rendered inaccessible, but thanks to the GT5 Master Mod once again, we can still drive it. And that was the last one. I hope you enjoyed it, I hope you learned something. And do let me know in the comments if there are any more cars that I should cover. Thank you for watching.